Welcome to the second tutorial in this series of sorting algorithms. This time I'll be discussing bubble sort. Like selection sort, bubble sort involves dividing the original list into a sorted section and an unsorted section. Its name refers to how the elements bubble up to the sorted section, located at the end of the list. This is accomplished by iterating through the list multiple times, swapping elements with their neighbors if they are not in the correct order. Each iteration is called a pass. At the end of each pass, the largest unsorted element will be positioned at the end of the unsorted section, which then becomes part of the sorted section. As you can see, this potentially requires many swaps for each pass, but we'll worry about that later. Let's take a look at the inner workings of this algorithm to see exactly how it works. Here we have an array of 4 cards, which is initially labeled as unsorted. The inner loop executes a single pass through the array, while the outer loop enables that pass to run multiple times. We start things off by stepping into the first pass. We'll be keeping track of how many comparisons are made in each pass. The letter C stands for current and will represent the element at our current position, while N stands for next and will represent the next element. Current always starts out at index 0. From there, we compare current to next and advance the larger of the two to be compared with the following element in the list. 6 is not greater than 7, so we simply increment current and try again. This time, current is greater than next, so we advance 7 up the list by swapping it with the 2 of clubs. Then increment current again. 7 is greater than 4, so they are swapped, positioning the 7 at the end of the unsorted section. It now becomes part of the sorted section and thus no longer needs to be compared against. Now for the second pass. As stated before, current starts at index 0 and is compared against the next element. 6 is greater than 2, so they are swapped and current is incremented to index 1. Again, 6 is greater than 4, so they're swapped. All elements have been compared, so 6 joins 7 in the sorted section. Time for our third and final pass. 2 is not greater than 4, so there's no need to swap. 4 becomes part of the sorted section, leaving the 2 of clubs as our lone remaining element. However, the last remaining element will always be in its correct position, so our job is finished. Now we'll walk through this same process with some actual C++ code and a different set of cards. Let's jump right in. If it's not already clear, n equals the number of elements in the array, in this case, 5. The outer loop will run n-1 times, from 1 to n-1. Why not n times? Because remember, the last remaining element doesn't require a pass. Next, we declare a Boolean variable to keep track of whether at least one swap takes place during this pass or not. In the inner loop, I represents the current index, and i+1 represents the next index. This loop executes while the current index I is less than n minus the current pass. Wait, where did n minus pass come from? Well, n minus pass tells us how many comparisons we'll need for a particular pass. In this first pass, it's 5-1, which is 4 comparisons. Let's review our results from the previous example to understand the logic. From this, we can see that the number of passes and number of comparisons are inversely proportional, which means as the number of passes increases, the number of comparisons decreases. So this loop will run fewer and fewer times, essentially keeping us contained within the unsorted section, since we don't want to waste time reanalyzing any of the sorted elements. For the first comparison, 3 is not greater than 9, so current index is simply incremented to 1. This time, 9 is greater than 3, so they are swapped. The Boolean variable is also updated to reflect this action. Current index is now incremented to position 2, where it's compared to its new neighbor, index 3. 9 is greater than 4, so they're swapped. Current is incremented to index 3 and is once again greater than next, so 9 is swapped to index 4. Because we have compared all unsorted elements, our first pass is complete, which means 9 becomes part of the sorted section. Now for an early exit condition. If no swaps take place during a given pass, we can safely assume that the list is already sorted. With that said, did we swap any elements during this pass? Yes, 9 was swapped 3 times in order for it to bubble up to the end, so we need to continue the algorithm. Notice that the list actually is sorted, but our program has no way of knowing this. We enter the second pass, set the swap flag to false, and start scanning the unsorted section. 3 is not greater than 3, so current is incremented to index 1. 3 is not greater than 4, so current is incremented to index 2. Once again, 4 is not greater than 8, and because all unsorted elements have now been compared, we exit the inner loop. Ah, this time there were no swaps, so our program can break out of the loop. We're done. That concludes this tutorial on the functionality and implementation of bubble sort. If you would like to delve into the analysis of this algorithm, click on the following link. Until next time, thanks for watching.